Hi everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on how to configure the React Floating Action Button component using the Create React App command and Syncfusion EJ2 React Buttons package. Using the React Floating Action Button component, you can create a circular or rounded button that appears to float above the user interface. In this video, I will show you how to configure the React Floating Action Button for the ListView target element and enable a few of its basic features. Let's start with the application creation process. Make sure you have installed the latest version of React and Node in your system. I'll use VS Code as my editor and show the output in the Chrome browser. First, I create a new application in the command prompt using the npx create React app command and provide the app name, My React App. To create a React app with TypeScript, I add template TypeScript. It will only take a few seconds to create the project. Second, I navigate to the project location. To use the floating action button, you need to install the Syncfusion buttons package. So run the command npm install Syncfusion EJ2 React buttons. Let's wait for the package to install. Third, I open the project in VS Code. Before using the Syncfusion components, I need to register the trial license key. I open the index.tsx file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. A license key is mandatory for React components to avoid license warnings. To see where to generate a trial license key, check the description below. Then, I open the app.css file and replace the default styles with the Syncfusion material CSS required for the floating action button. I open the app.tsx file and remove the default code snippets. In this video, instead of simply placing the floating action button somewhere on the page, I will show you how to position it in the bottom right corner of the ListView component and enable the functionality of adding a contact name by clicking the FAB button. First, I install the Syncfusion React Lists package to use React ListView component. npm install Syncfusion EJ2 React Lists. Let's wait for the package to install. Once installation is completed, I import the ListView component from the React Lists package and include the ListView component code with a header. To learn more about integrating the ListView component into a React application, please check the Getting Started video linked in the card above and description below. Now I'll run this example by running the command npm start. As you can see, the list view is rendered with the provided data source. To use the floating action button, I import that component from the Syncfusion EJ2 React Buttons package and include the floating action button component tag. Then, to place this button over a list view, I add the target property and assign the list view ID. And to display the icon in the button, I add the icon CSS property. I add the required icon classes like eIcons, ePlus, and eSmall. To align the floating action button over the list view component, I add the position relative style to the list view. See, the floating action button is placed over the list view. I'm going to add a new contact to this list when the button is clicked. I add the onClick event to the floating action button component and assign the callback method onButtonClick. I define this method here. To add a new item to this list, I can use ListView's built-in method, addItem. To access this method, I need to add the ref property in the ListView. So, I declare a variable, ListObject, of type ListView component, and use it in the ref property. Inside this callback method, I declare the array with a single item. Then, using the list object, I call the addItem method and assign this array object. Looking here, when I click this button, the provided name is added to the list view. Next, I will show you how to position the icon on the button. To demonstrate this, I set the content to this button. By default, the icon is positioned to the left with the text. You can position the icon at the top, right, or bottom by adding the icon position property. I assign the value right. Checking now, the icon is positioned on the right side of the button. You can also customize the position of the floating action button anywhere on the target using the position property. The available options are top left, top center, top right, middle left, and so on. The default option is the bottom right. I set the position to top right. And now the button is positioned in the top right corner of list view. Finally, I will show you the built-in styles, primary, secondary, outline, and so on. By default, the primary button is rendered. To apply the outline style, I add the CSS class property and assign the value eOutline. I change back the button position to bottom right and icon position to left. And now, the outline style is applied. In this video, I have shown you how to create and configure the Syncfusion React floating action button component using the create React app command and how to use a few of its basic features. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also shared a link where you can learn about obtaining a free license key to use our React products if you're eligible for our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.